next question from mic number 3 in the rare section, gents.
Good evening, sir. I thank you for the word that a purpose of life which is given today, and you have given the surahs and the ayat from the Quran. Surah 1788 says, if all mankind and the jinn would come together to produce the like of this Quran, they could not produce it. But History of Al-Tabari, volume 6, page 107, Ibn Shahad, Kitab Al-Tabqat, Al-Kabir, volume 1, parts 1 and 2, pages 236 and 239, Ibn Ishaq, Sirat Rasulullah, page number 165-167, says that Muhammad was inspired by the Satan and spoken on behalf of three gods, goddess, Allahat, Al-Uzza, and Mannat, saying that their intercession is hoped for. After some time, later upon receiving further revelation from angel Jibril, that those verses were not from Allah, but inspired by Satan. My question is, this incident has several implications. The challenges of the Quran to bring the surah like it in Surah 1788 was actually met by those satanic words in Muhammad's own time, right? Which in turn leads to the conclusion that the rest of the Quran, is this from Allah either?
Brother, what's your name?
I'm Danny, I'm a student. I'm studying on the book.
Brother Danny has asked a very good question.
Yes, sir.
That he quoted Surah Isra, chapter 17, verse number 88. That says that if all the men and jinns got together to produce the like of the Quran, they will not be able to do it. That's also repeated in Surah Thur, chapter number 52, verse number 34. Just to help you out. And I'll give you more references. But he said, quoting Tabari and etc., that this verse of the Quran was from Satan. Maybe you read it wrong. It was an allegation that people said these words of the Quran are from Satan, and immediately the revelation came of Surah Waqia, chapter 56, verse number 77-80, saying that this book is well preserved, who none shall touch except those who are pure, a book well guarded by the Lord of the worlds. This verse came to say that no one be able to touch the Quran in Lohe Mehfooz, in tablet well preserved, except the mutahareen, that is the pure angels, indicating that the Satans can come close nowhere to the Quran. So this was an allegation laid by the mushriks of Makkah on the Prophet that this is a Satan handiwork. In reply to this, there are various verses. Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse 82, Quran says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرَانِ وَلَوْ قَانَ مِنْ إِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوْجَدُوا فِي اِكْتِلَافٍ كَثِيرًا. Do they not consider the Quran with K? Had it been from anyone besides Allah, there would have been many contradictions. Besides this, please let me reply, brother. Besides this, what you mentioned, Allah gives a challenge that if you say it's from Satan, in Surah Thur, chapter 52, verse number 34, and Surah Isra, chapter 17, verse 18, that if all the men and the jinns got together, they would not be able to produce the like of the Quran. Then Allah makes the challenge easier. Allah says in Surah Hud, chapter number 11, verse number 13, I'm giving you more material to attack. Allah says in Surah Hud, chapter number 11, verse number 13, if all the men and the jinns got together, they will not be able to produce 10 surahs like the Quran. Allah makes the challenge easier. Brother, do you want to listen to the answer or not?
Yeah, go ahead, please. Sorry. Please go ahead.
You are...
Later on, actually, I just wanted to add...
Brother.
Please go ahead, sir. Brother, later on, add it.
This is not a debate time.
No, sir.
It's a question-answer time. You finish your question, your question is over. Now listen to my answer.
So should I add it, then you give an answer that will be easy for me to understand.
But why didn't you add it in the first place?
Because it's... Now you're telling something, then I have to add it.
So then you go behind the queue and then add. No problem. Go behind the Q&A.
No, because there were many verses which was saying that.
I'm helping you.
Okay. Sorry, sir. Please go ahead.
Furthermore, it's mentioned Allah makes the challenge easier. Allah says in Surah Yunus, chapter number 10, verse number 38, that if all the men and jinn got together, they will not be able to produce a surah like the Quran. Allah makes it much more easier. In Surah Baqarah, chapter 2, verse number 23 and 24, Allah says that وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبِ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِمِثْلِ. And if you are in doubt as what we have revealed to our servant Prophet Muhammad from time to time, produce a surah somewhat similar, mimmisli, not exactly, somewhat similar, mimmisli. وَدْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. And call forth your helpers and witnesses if there are besides Allah, if your doubts are but true. فَإِلَّمْ تَفَلُوا. But if you cannot, وَلَنْ تَفَلُوا. And of a surety you cannot. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسَ وَالْحِجَارَةُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Then fear the fire whose fuel is men and stones, which is prepared for those who reject faith. This is a challenge. It's a standing challenge. Many people tried to produce a surah like the Quran, but they failed miserably. The language of the Quran is so divine, is so pure. Not that people didn't try. When the Quran was revealed, Arabic was at its peak. It was at its peak. The Arabs, they were proud of the language. Allah says, with your language, I have produced the Quran. Try and produce a single surah, somewhat similar, not exactly. And some surahs of the Quran, one surah is hardly 3 verses, hardly 10 words only. Many people tried, they failed miserably. If you think this is from anyone besides Allah, you try and produce a surah. That's a challenge. No one has done it, neither can you do it. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you.